CIET NCERT presents curriculum based series Dhwani Shala. So let's join in Dhwani Shala class 6.
Hello my young friends, how are you? I hope you all are healthy and safe at your place. I am your friend Anjali. You know what we are going to study today? Something which is everyone's favorite and hearing which you feel delighted and your taste buds get active. Now, can you guess the word? Right, that is food. So, we will be studying class 6, chapter 1, that is food, where does it come from? Okay, tell me, why do we eat food? We eat food because we feel hungry? Right. But have you ever wondered, how do we do so many activities like studying, running, sleeping, dancing, etc.? And after doing all these activities, we feel hungry. So, what does it require then to feel active? These all activities require energy. Where does this energy come from? Can you relate? Yes, dear children, through food only. We require energy to perform all our tasks, and this energy comes from food which we eat. Now let me ask you, tell me, what did you eat at home today? Maybe rice, roti, pulses, vegetables, curd, milk or anything like this? Did you eat the same kind of food yesterday and today? I know, all of you must have the same answer, that is no. We eat different food items every day. And no one likes to eat the same food on a routine basis. We eat different food items every day. Because no one likes to eat the same food in every meal, right? So you do this activity, ask your friends in the school about the items they would be eating during the day or night. See, if you can also get the same information from your friends or relatives staying in different states of India. List all the items in your notebook for as many people as possible. And you would get to know we all eat different kind of food items at different times, isn't it? Why is variety so important? Can you eat the same roti and dal all the time? No. Each variety of food which we eat will have different kind of nutrients. So a diet having all kind of nutrients, that is a balanced diet, is important for a healthy body and mind. In a diverse culture like in India, where every state has its own food taste and flavor, there is a lot of variation in the food eaten in different regions of India. Can you guess the famous food item of Rajasthan? Guess? Dal bati? Right. For Kerala, it is known for dosa and sambar. For Gujarat, it is dhokla. Punjab is famous for makke ki roti and sarson ka saag. West Bengal for fish. And is similar for another states which have their own food flavor. So, what are these food items made of? We use different raw materials to make a different variety of foods. The raw material used in making food are called ingredients. Think about rice cooked at home. We take rice and boil it in water. We take raw rice and boil it in water. Just two materials or ingredients are needed to prepare a dish of boiled rice. To prepare roti or chapati, flour and water are required. A dough is prepared by mixing flour and water. then chapatis are made from that dough. You must have seen at your home when chapatis are made in the kitchen. It is simple to make rice and chapati because simple two ingredients are required. But there are several dishes also which require many ingredients. Some food items are made with few ingredients and some food items are made with many ingredients. To prepare dal, pulses, ghee or oil, different spices and salt are required. They all are mixed in an appropriate amount and cooked. Likewise, for vegetable curry, we need different kinds of vegetables, salt, spices, oil and so on. Now, to understand it much better, try this second activity at home. Try to find out what ingredients are used to prepare different kinds of food. Similar to as we discussed, list some more examples by helping your elder or parent while cooking in the kitchen. You will definitely have this observation that some ingredients are common for different food items and many ingredients are not common for different food items. So, where do these food ingredients come from? Now, it may be easy for you to guess the sources of some of the ingredients. Let us discuss some of them. From where do we get milk? Yes, your answer is correct. We get milk from cows, buffaloes, and goats. Next question. From where do we get fruits and vegetables? Yes, your answer is right. We get fruits and vegetables from plants. So we come to know that raw material or food ingredients come from different plants and animals, of course. What are the sources of rice or wheat? You may have seen paddy or wheat fields with rows and rows of plants which gives us these grains. And then there are food items like milk, eggs and meat which come from animals. So here comes the third activity for the day. Take the food items which are easily available at your home and try to find out where they come from, their ingredients and their sources. For instance, when yummy kheer is made at home, what are its ingredients? Its ingredients are milk, whose source is an animal. Rice, whose source are plants, and sugar, that too come from plant source. Similar to this, complete this activity of collecting the food items and observing and noting their ingredients and sources. After completing this activity, show it to your parents, elders, and teachers and make it verify. So, what we have seen? Plants are the source of food ingredients like grains, cereals, vegetables, and fruit. Animals provide us with milk, meat products, and eggs. Cows, goats, and buffaloes are some common animals which gives us milk and milk products like butter, cream, cheese, and curd. They all are the derivatives of milk. So we say, dairy products also fall under animal sources. Now we shall learn about parts of plants. We all now know plants are an important source of our food. What are the various parts of plant which we can see with the naked eye? Those are flowers, fruits, stems, leaves, and roots. Can we eat all of these parts? No. Then which part of a plant can we eat? We eat the leaves of some plants, like many leafy vegetables. We eat fruits from some plants, sometimes roots, sometimes stem, and even flowers of some plants are also edible. As a source of food, we can say plants are very versatile. It means they are varied because they provide us with numerous variety of food. Let us now learn some more examples. We eat leaves of spinach called as palak, fenugreek called as methi, mustard called as sarso, and etc. What are the examples of fruits which you like? Apple, banana, mango, peach. These all are the fruits of plants that we eat. Seeds of some plants are also edible. Example, spices, pulses, and cereals. Edible oil is also obtained from seeds. The roots of some plants are also edible. For example, carrot, radish, beetroot, turnip, and so on. Whereas the stem part of plants like onion, sugarcane, ginger, garlic, and underground stem like potato are also edible. The examples of flowers which are edible are cauliflower, rose flower, etc. Have you ever eaten pumpkin flowers dipped in rice paste and fried? Try it. It really tastes yummy. Some plants have two or more edible parts. Think of more examples where two or more parts of a single plant are edible and used as food. Let me give you some of the examples and then you explore further. For example, mustard plant. We get oil from its seeds and their leaves are used as a vegetable. Can you think of the different parts of a banana plant? We eat its fruit, banana stem, and flower as well. Its leaves are also used as a plate for serving food. Therefore, it is a multi-utility plant. Can you name any plant which grows in water and can be used as food material? Think. Okay, so its answer is lotus. Lotus grows in water, as we all know, and it can be used as food material also. Do you know any of our food which comes from sources other than plants and animals? Guess what it might be? These are mushrooms. Mushrooms are edible fungi, which are neither plants nor animals. Explore more examples of the same kind, where food can be derived from sources other than plants and animals. Let us have a quick go through with one example of food item, that is brinjal curry. Tell me, what are its ingredients? Brinjal, chili as spice, oil, which can be from groundnut or mustard or soya bean. What are their sources? What are the sources of food ingredients? Brinjal from a plant source, and the part of plant is fruit. Chili also from fruit of a plant, and oil from seeds of a plant source. So my dear students, you can also analyze and see the different parts of plant source which are edible. But be cautious, parts of all plants are not edible. Do not try to taste unknown plants around you to see if they are edible, because some plants could be poisonous. Now we shall understand the process of seed germination, which means how seeds germinate and how plants grow. Visualize yourself by performing this activity at your home. Take some gram seeds like dry seeds of moong or chana. Put a small quantity of seeds in a container filled with water and leave this aside for a day. Next day, dry that water completely. Next day, drain the water completely and leave the seeds in a vessel. Wrap them with a wrap them with a piece of damp cloth and set aside. On the following day, you will observe some changes in the seeds. What you will observe? You will observe a small white structure may have grown out of the seeds. If so, the seeds have sprouted. If still not you can see this, not to worry. Again wash the seeds in water, drain the water and leave them aside for another day, but covered with a damp cloth. The next day, see if the seeds have sprouted. After washing these sprouted seeds, you can eat them. They can also be boiled, add some spices in it, and you would get a tasty snack to eat. Let us now study some animal products. Animal products like milk and its derivatives, eggs, chicken, fish, etc. My dear children, what source comes to your mind when you hear the word honey? Yes, honeybees. Do you know where honey comes from? Or how it is produced? Let me tell you. Bees collect nectar. Nectar is a sweet juice which is present in flowers. So, bees collect nectar from flowers, convert it into honey, and store it in their hive. Flowers and their nectar may be available only for a part of the year. So, bees store this nectar for their use all through the year. When we find such a beehive, we collect the food stored by the bees as honey. Have you seen a beehive where so many bees keep buzzing about? Some of you might have, but be careful, never disturb their nectar. Now let us see what animals eat. Children, tell me, do you have cattle or... Children, tell me, do you have a cattle or a pet that you take care of? A dog? Cat? Cow? Buffalo? Or a goat? You will be then surely aware of the food the animals eat. Like buffalo eat grass, oil cake, hay, grains. And what do cats eat? They eat small animals, birds, and drink milk. What do rabbits eat? Rabbits eat grass or plant-based food. What about other animals? Have you ever observed a squirrel, pigeon, lizard, or a small insect around you? What they may be eating as their food? This method of eating choice of food is known as a food habit. And different animals have different food habits. Animals which eat only plants or plant-based products are called herbivores. Rabbits eat carrots, cows eat grass. So what are these animals? Yes, herbivores. Similarly, there are some animals which eat other animals. These animals are called carnivores. Similarly, there are some animals which eat other animals. These animals are called carnivores. For example, lion, tiger, lizards. Lion eat deer, zebras and other herbivorous animals. And what about lizards? They eat insects. Do you know some animals which eat both plants and animals? Yes, the third category is omnivorous. Humans which eat both plants as well as animals are called omnivorous. Similarly, dogs are also omnivorous. Now you think, my dear children, does everyone around you get enough food to eat? So, dear students, what we have learned today, let us recapitulate it once. There is a lot of variation in the food eaten in different regions of India. The main sources of food are plants and animals. And what we have discussed about the edible parts of plants? Those are stems, leaves, fruits, roots, and flowers. At the last, what we have seen that the animal can be divided into three categories depending upon the type of food they eat. That is herbivorous, carnivorous and omnivorous. Now you think, my dear children, does everyone around you get enough food to eat? We know that there are many amongst us who do not get sufficient food. We need to find ways by which more food can be produced in the country. Even then, if it will not be enough, we will need to find ways to ensure that this food is made easily available to each and every one of us. So remember, never ever waste your food and think more of the ways to avoid wastage of food. With this, we conclude our chapter. I hope that you have understood it well. Keep learning by reading more books. Stay safe and healthy by eating healthy. Thank you.
You are just listening to curriculum-based programs, Dhwani Shala. Production assistants, Meenakshi Kukreti, Tanu Gupta and Jagbandhu Jana. Recorded by Bati Langlingdo and produced by Vandana Arimardhan. This program was brought to you by CIET NCERT, New Delhi, India.